Robert Pataki, aka Big Bob. Big Bob was the patriarch of the Pataki family. He was the husband of Marion Pataki and the father of Olga and Helga Pataki. Big Bob's signature look included a green golf shirt with a golden crown on it and dark brown pants. He had neat gray hair combed to the side and a gray unibrow to match. One of Big Bob's major features was his preoccupation with winning and success. He was a motivated and driven entrepreneur who founded a pager store called Big Bob's Beepers. Big Bob's company was a pretty successful one. I mean, he was able to support a family of four on his own and live pretty comfortably too. Big Bob's career wasn't just a way for him to support his family, it also formed much of his identity. While Big Bob owned a pager store, he actually first wanted to start an appliance store.
To make enough money as an actor to start my own major appliance chain.
Appliance chain. That was my dream.
Oh, gee.
It'll be the son I never had. And one day, Big Bob's Beeper Emporium will be all yours.
Big Bob didn't just have a drive for success, I would say he had a pretty unhealthy obsession with winning. We saw this multiple times throughout the series, like during the season 3 episode, Parents' Day. When Helga didn't perform as well as he hoped, he reminds her how losing just isn't an option. Big Bob's winning complex was most notably seen in the season 4 episode titled Grudge Match.
Well, what do you know? We got ourselves a good old-fashioned fender bender.
What are you, blind, you old buzzard? Look at my car, it's total. This is your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
My fault? You backed right into it.
You brought your checkbook.
You'll never get a dime out of me, Pataki.
Oh, yeah?
The two agree to settle the issue of who would pay for the damages with a game of golf. In the end, despite practicing for the game, Big Bob actually lost. Big Bob's competitiveness extended to his expectations to his family. It wasn't enough for him to always win, his family had to win as well. This was clear while watching his relationship with his eldest daughter, Olga. Olga was a high-achieving student that made Big Bob beaming with pride. He encouraged and supported her to be the best, and she strived to live up to his expectations. While Big Bob praised his daughter and pushed her to success, he actually didn't mind when she came up short. This is evident in the episode Olga Comes Home. In that episode, Olga thinks she got a B on her report card and is devastated. In contrast, Big Bob doesn't see what the big deal was.
I just can't stand to see her like this. Plus.
He even tries to make her feel better by buying her a new dress. Olga feels pressured by her parents, yet never confronts them about it. This shows how there was a lack of communication between Olga and her father, resulting in a relationship that looked picture perfect on the outside, but really wasn't.
You must think I'm lucky, all the attention I get from them. I have to perform all the time like some kind of wind-up doll. I get really sick of it. You're lucky they don't even notice you.
There were standards Olga believed she needed to reach in order to be accepted by her parents. In contrast, it appears her parents weren't as strict as she might have thought. In the episode Olga Gets Engaged, it's clear how Big Bob wanted what was best for Olga.
Save the best news for last. I've met a wonderful boy and I'm dropping out of school to marry him and move to the big city.
What is this, some kind of joke?
No, Dad. That's the best thing that's ever happened to me. He's handsome and dreamy, and he's a fabulous actor. Of course, he's not famous yet, so I'll get a job and support us both. But isn't it romantic?
No, you're throwing your life away!
Big Bob is furious. He valued her education and wanted her to have a secure future. He saw her decision as spontaneous and reckless, and didn't want her to ruin the promising life she was building for herself. In the end though, Big Bob makes a tough decision and puts aside his own judgment, siding with Olga. He decides that her happiness is more important than his expectations of what her life should look like. Big Bob's obsession with the success of Olga left Helga ignored and neglected. Sometimes Big Bob even called her Olga.
She's won every spelling bee in the whole darn city. Makes me proud to be a Pataki.
Hey, who's taking me to preschool?
Yeah, in a minute, Olga.
No, I'm Helga, Dad. Helga.
Whatever.
His strained relationship with Helga was much more obvious than the complicated one he had with Olga. With that said though, Big Bob's competitive nature extended to her as well. This is evident in the season 1 episode, Spelling Bee. In that episode, Helga competes in a spelling bee competition to win a $500 cash prize. Big Bob raises the stakes by making a commercial that promises everyone a free beeper if Helga loses. He then reminisces about how Olga won the competition when she was younger and how now it was time that Helga did the same.
And all you gotta do is win. You hear me? Win. Win! Win!
Okay, Dad. I'll do my best.
Big Bob was so desperate for Helga to win that he even bribed Arnold with a check for $500 to let her win. This not only shows how Big Bob wasn't afraid to behave in unethical ways, but he also didn't have faith in Helga's ability to win on her own. The end of the episode concludes with Helga losing the competition on purpose to get back at her dad. The disappointment and public loss is too much for Big Bob to handle, so he runs away. While Big Bob wasn't the best parent to Helga, he did show that he cared for her. We saw this in the season 2 episode, Quantity Time. In the beginning of the episode, Miriam announces she's going to visit her mother, leaving Helga and her dad at home. It then becomes obvious that Big Bob knows nothing about his 9-year-old daughter. Once Big Bob realizes his lack of connection with his daughter, he tries to make up for it by surprising her with tickets to a show that he thinks she wants to see. Unfortunately, he buys tickets to the wrong show. Helga and Big Bob end up watching a show that neither of them want to see. It turns out Helga and her dad had a lot more in common than they had.
It's so beautiful. And so true. This is the stupidest thing I've ever seen.
I know. It's horrible.
Finally, we've got something we can hate together.
Big Bob saw winning as a family trait.
Oh, she's won every spelling bee in the whole darn city. Makes me proud to be a Pataki.
Patakis were winners, and even though Big Bob forgot Helga existed sometimes, she was still a Pataki. Big Bob's wife, Miriam Pataki, however, challenged the notion that the Patakis were winners. Miriam was very passive and displayed a lack of ambition.
Leave her alone, Bee. She's depressed.
It's been a whole day. She can't just lay around the house moping like that.
Sure she can. I do.
Well, it's not healthy.
When she and Bob met, she was full of ambition and was a high achiever. Just like Olga. That was who Big Bob fell in love with, a strong and successful woman with a bright future ahead. This complemented Big Bob's equally ambitious attitude.
I am woman, hear me roar.
However, at some point during their marriage, Miriam lost her lust for life. Miriam has suggested that she believes getting married to Big Bob was the reason for her downward spiral.
But isn't it romantic?
No, you're throwing your life away.
Big Bob's lack of awareness on how Miriam feels about her life shows how their marriage lacked communication, transparency, and honesty. In the episode Beeper Queen, we saw how Big Bob really feels about Miriam. In that episode, Big Bob needs someone to run his business while he recovers from an injury. Now he was stuck at home and unable to provide for his family. When Miriam suggested to take on the role, Big Bob responds with sarcasm. He just didn't believe that his wife was capable of running his successful business on her own. But then, Miriam proved that she could not only manage his company, but also made it even more successful than Big Bob did. During this time, Miriam also stops drinking and becomes more focused. This supports the idea that Big Bob was the reason she started drinking. Instead of responding with pride or happiness at his wife's success, his response is one of indifference. Big Bob was so used to his wife being an absent-minded housewife that perhaps her new ambition threatened his role in the family. He was the one who was in charge, and everyone just did what he said. Now, it was Miriam who was calling the shots and essentially beating him at his own game. While Big Bob initially fell in love with a strong-willed and talented woman, as their marriage progressed, he now prioritized her ability to be a supportive wife and a mother instead. A question I have is, where did Big Bob's competitive nature come from? Perhaps he suffers from low self-esteem and needed to win in order to feel good about himself. Maybe his parents pressured him to always win like he pressures Olga. What do you think? Aside from Big Bob's career and family life, as an individual, he had many interests and hobbies. For example, Big Bob had a love for high-tech electronics. In the season 1 episode, Roughin' It, Big Bob drives a futuristic RV souped up with high-tech gadgets like a solar-powered generator and a GPS. This also shows how Big Bob valued a high standard of living, because he could have easily made a traditional campsite like Arnold's grandpa, but decided against it. We saw Big Bob's lifestyle challenged in the episode Big Bob's Crisis. This is actually my favorite episode that features Big Bob. The episode starts off by showcasing the entrepreneur's lack of customer service skills and complete disregard to those less fortunate than him.
Smell vamoose before I call a cop.
Scammers. Mister.
What do you want?
I was wondering if you make a donation to my orphanage. The money will send poor kids to summer camp for a week.
Hey, who do I look like? Mother Teresa? I'm running a business here, kid. Now scram!
Later on, Big Bob suffers from what he thought was a heart attack while eating dinner. He then has a Christmas Carol-like type of dream where he sees himself from another perspective and realizes how his actions have affected others. His experience completely changes his outlook on life. He didn't want to be the same person anymore. An arrogant and stubborn person. His drive to be the best was preoccupying his mind to the point where it superseded his sense of morality. His experience allowed him to take a step back and think about what really mattered to him, his mental and physical health, as well as his family. This sets Big Bob on a path to inner peace, tranquility, and a simpler life. He starts learning how he can live in the moment, starts to meditate, begins to play the sitar, and even donates all of his family's furniture to an orphanage. Big Bob's dramatic shift from a self-centered and materialistic lifestyle to a minimalist one is at first a shock to his family.
How will we walk barefoot to Oregon?
Barefoot to Oregon?
Yeah, to live in a commune.
However, eventually, they were all on board with his plan. Except for Helga. In fact, Helga was the one who ended up changing Big Bob's mind when he initially planned to move the family to a commune. She missed her dad and didn't like how he became a whole new person.
This is the evil past that I'm running away from.
It's great, isn't it?
Looks for me with the funny hat on.
Don't you see? You were the king, Dad.
I was a horrible, uptight money monger.
No, you were more than that.
The old Bob pushed himself too hard, little lady. He never stopped to smell of roses, to enjoy life's rich pageant, or really explore his spiritual core. Plus, he was a big, fat jerk.
But Bob, you have done so much. I mean, look, you built this place from the ground up and you did it your way. You never let anybody tell you what to do. And now look at you with all this happy sunshine junk. You're just a sheep.
Helga made her father realize that there was a good side to his former self. Ultimately, Big Bob decided what mattered most was that they had each other, no matter where they lived. So while Big Bob on the surface was stubborn and arrogant, he was also a kind-hearted family man. We watched him desperate to win at competitions, but also desperate to win the hearts of his children. Big Bob developed into a character who not only recognized the error of his ways, but was also committed to becoming both a better father and a better individual. This was one of the things I loved about watching Hey Arnold. The adult characters like Big Bob were complex and not flat nor stereotypical. He wasn't the best father, but once he realized a mistake he made, he tried to fix it. Mistakes are just a part of life, and watching the show as a kid made it clear how adults didn't have all the answers, and that was okay. So with that, we are now at the end of my Hey Arnold character analysis of Robert Big Bob Pataki. What did you think of Big Bob? Let me know in the comments down below. If you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. You can also find me on Instagram and TikTok at dialupdigest. Until next time, my friends, dialing out.